You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Welcome to Newspeak South Asia, a program that talks about breeding of terrorism and its impact on South Asian nations. Let's begin with the headlines first. Indian National Investigation Agency busts ISIS terror module in Kashmir. Indian forces step up offensive against Pak-backed terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir. And 9 Chinese nationals killed in Pakistan bus blast. The rapid advancement in digital technology has acted like a boon for the process of globalization. But for some, it has become a weapon for spreading the wings of terrorism. Terrorist groups like the Islamic State have been using social media and their digital publications to influence youth and lure them towards jihad. Recently, Indian investigation agencies carried out massive raids in 10 different locations in Jammu and Kashmir and busted a new ISIS module which was conspiring to radicalize and recruit gullible youth in the valley to wage a violent jihad against India.
Receiving a shot in the arm, Indian investigation agencies busted a new ISIS terror module in Kashmir this week. The National Investigation Agency carried out massive raids in 10 different locations in Anantnag, Srinagar, Avantipura and Baramulla in connection with the conspiracy to spread the Islamic State propaganda through online mediums. 5 people, including a person named Umar Bhatt, was arrested by the agencies who were running the digital editions of a radical magazine that was being published in order to radicalize the gullible youth in the valley to wage violent jihad against India. From the expansion of extremist groups and their worldwide recruitment policies, it has become evident that the threat of terrorism is not restricted to its region of origin anymore. The mass use of the internet and social media has obscured the borders of extremism and has imposed an undeniable menace to global peace.
These people, using their fake identities, fake YouTube channels, give a propaganda that in India there is a lot of misuse being done with the Muslims. They are not being allowed to offer their namaz, they are not being allowed to follow their religion, and there are total atrocities being done on them. And this is what I would say gets into the minds of the youngsters and others, and what happens is that these youngsters, they join this, and then before they realize, they are caught into that web, because sooner or later, once they have joined, they would be speaking something or sending some messages which could be used by the security agencies, and there is where they are blackmailed to stay on and do the work of the diktats of the terrorist organization.
As per the security forces, ISIS terrorists operating from various conflict zones along with ISIS cadres in India, by assuming pseudo-online identities, have created a network wherein ISIS-related propaganda material is disseminated for radicalizing and recruiting members into its fold. In this connection, an India-centric online propaganda magazine, The Voice of Hind, was being published on monthly basis with an aim to incite and radicalize vulnerable youth by projecting a skewed narrative of imagined injustices in India to arouse a feeling of alienation and communal hatred. It was founded by the key commander of the Islamic State in the Khurasan province and a highly trained Pakistani national. After his death, a new module took over the magazine that reappeared on the dark web a few months ago. Similarly, the Al-Qaeda affiliate for the Indian subcontinent also released the online edition of its magazine to pursue its anti-India agenda in Kashmir. The terror group changed the name of its magazine, Nawai Afghan Jihad or Voice of the Afghan Jihad, to Nawai Ghazwai Hind or Voice of the Conquest of India in the early part of 2020.
Now, what these terrorist organizations do is they are using the social media, misusing, I would say, the social media, the internet, and also magazines and other flyers. In the social media, they have formed various groups in WhatsApp and others, Instagram and others, and under, again, cloaked names, which keep on feeding wrong information, doctored photographs to these in the group. And this is how they are making an impression on the minds of the youngsters. Similarly, now even your other emails and even your Instagram and your Facebook, those are these channels are such that there is no check on it. And what happens is, whatever the youngsters see in that, they feel that this is the truth, and therefore, whosoever is sending this is telling us the truth. And this, they find that it is more easy to be digested and follow the dictates of these people.
Pakistan's intelligence agency and terror groups are now invading cyberspace for recruitment in Jammu and Kashmir, as direct physical interactions have become difficult due to the security forces' hawk-eyed vigil. They no longer rely on military force such as weapons, armor, and bombs only. Instead, they have become more and more savvy, and their strategies and tactics have gained technological orientation. Terrorist groups like Al-Qaeda, Jaish-e-Mohammed, Lashkar-e-Taiba and Islamic State are at the forefront of using the internet for their recruitment. In January 2021, two terrorists arrested in Kashmir were provided training online using various links available on public platforms like YouTube and were receiving orders as well as religious teachings from Pakistan-based handler Burhan Hamza. Earlier, Amir Siraj, a final year graduation student from Khwaja Gilgit in Sopore, was also recruited online by Jaish-e-Mohammed. He was gunned down during an encounter between terrorists and security forces. Fake videos of alleged atrocities committed by the security forces and building a false narrative are now often used by the ISI handlers from Pakistan to whip up emotions among the new recruits. Meanwhile, a wide range of terrorist groups have also used the internet to raise and transfer funds needed to support their activities. According to the Indian investigation agencies, in order to execute their devious plans, an organized campaign has been launched over cyberspace, which is supplemented by on-ground terror financing activities.
While Pakistan is trying hard to revive violence in Kashmir, India is committed to fighting all their tricks to stop its western neighbor from inciting terror in the valley. The Indian security forces, despite suffering losses, managed to foil all its devious agendas. Once again, continuing with the spate of encounters that have taken place recently in the valley, Indian security forces eliminated at least five terrorists hiding in Pulwama and Srinagar district of Kashmir.
A counter-terrorism offensive aimed at wiping out Pakistan-backed terrorists from Jammu and Kashmir has gained fresh momentum with the killing of as many as three terrorists, including a Pakistani terrorist, Ejaz alias Abu Herrera, who was the top commander of Lashkar-e-Taiba. The encounter had started after a joint team of Jammu and Kashmir police and security forces launched a search operation on the basis of specific information about the presence of terrorists in the area. Incriminating material, including arms and ammunition, were also recovered by the security forces.
कल इवनिंग में श्रीनगर पुलिस को एक इत्तला मिली थी कि पुलवामा टाउन में तीन टेररिस्ट एलईटी के छिपे हुए हैं, तो श्रीनगर पुलिस, पुलवामा पुलिस, आर्मी, सीआरपी मिलकर कॉर्डन किया। कॉर्डन करने के बाद मिलिटेंट ने अंदर से ग्रेनेड फायर थ्रो किया, फिर फायरिंग किया। हम रिटेलिएट किए, क्योंकि सिविलियन बीच में फंसे हुए थे, इसलिए हम ऑपरेशन को रोक दिए। सिविलियन को पहले इवैक्यूएट किए वहाँ से, फिर आज अर्ली मॉर्निंग में इनकाउंटर रिज्यूम हुआ, जिसमें तीन टेररिस्ट मारे गए।
Indian armed forces have lately intensified their efforts to decimate terrorism from the valley. Major operations in the last few days have resulted in the killing of several terrorists. Many others have also been apprehended. Rattled by continuous failures, Pakistan has been adopting and adapting terror tactics from other theaters, like drones to drop weapons, online terror recruitment, and introducing IEDs in Kashmir. However, India is effectively thwarting all its devious agendas. Recently, Indian Army deployed a high-tech surveillance system near Pakistan border areas in Kashmir amid the rising threats of drones.
Their terror activities are getting foiled, and that is why Pakistan is getting frustrated, and it is coming out into the valley with many terror activities. And this is a fact that there are two encounters going on today, and in one of the encounters there is a Pakistani terrorist named Ejaz who has been killed. Now Pakistan's frustration is showing to the entire world. If Pakistan thinks that the entire world is sitting with closed eyes, Pakistan is sadly mistaken.
Meanwhile, India and Pakistan agreed to reduce tensions and maintain a ceasefire along the border in the valley in the beginning of this year. But there is no commitment from Islamabad to stop sponsoring terror. Last week, Indian security forces successfully foiled the first infiltration bid by Pakistan after the February 25 agreement and eliminated two Pakistani terrorists along the LOC. This has created an atmosphere of fear and terror among the locals. Residents say that life at the border is very risky, and they always live in constant fear that cross-border firing can resume at any point in time. Noordin, a resident of Poonch, says he was happy that the cross-border shelling has been halted, but deep down his heart, he was scared that their lives will be in danger if Pakistan starts shelling once again.
बाकी बॉर्डर का जो ज़िंदगी है तो बहुत अजीब ज़िंदगी है ना गोलीबारी तो अभी दो तीन महीने हुए बंद है तो इसका भी कोई भरोसा नहीं है कि कब चलेगा कोई मुश्किल कोई पता नहीं है कब से शुरू हो जाएंगे बॉर्डर का ऐसा ही होता है तो बॉर्डर की ज़िंदगी हम बहुत मुश्किल से गुजार रहे हैं
Despite all the embarrassment and name-calling at various global forums, Pakistan continues to use terrorism as an instrument of its state policy. In a sophisticated world where the other countries are looking forward to establishing peace, harmony, and developing new technologies for the advancement of the world settlement, Pakistan's state policy of terrorism is causing violence and is creating an environment of distrust in the world.
Moving on to Afghanistan, where the Taliban are on the march and claims to be gaining territory at an astonishing rate. As most American and NATO combat troops have left Afghanistan, the withdrawal has raised security concerns in the country. Pakistan has taken advantage of the pulling out of the foreign troops and has openly supported the Taliban to gain the stronghold and fight against the Afghan government.
Taliban terrorists freely cross into Afghanistan from Pakistan on motorbikes and other vehicles. There are no bars on their movement at the international border. Even the Taliban fighters killed in Afghanistan are brought back to Kuchlak in Pakistan's Balochistan province for burial. Since the US-led NATO combat troops started leaving the country after 20 years of war, the Taliban is on a deadly rampage. At this crucial time, Pakistan has again been exposed when its own lawmaker from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Mohsin Dawar, launched a tirade against the country's establishment for its support to the Taliban. Speaking in the Pakistan National Assembly, Mohsin said the Taliban are Pakistan's favorites in Afghanistan.
हम जब यहाँ पर कहते हैं कि यहाँ से लोग जा रहे हैं, यहाँ से लोग दहशतगर्द वहाँ पर एक्सपोर्ट हो रहे हैं, फिर वहाँ से फवाद चौधरी साहब कहते हैं कि ये अमरुल्ला साले की ज़बान बोल रहे हैं। बाबा अमरुल्ला साले जो इल्जामात लगा रहे हैं उसको जस्टिफाई करने के लिए उसको साबित करने के लिए उसको किसी सबूत की जरूरत नहीं है आपका अपना वजीर खारजा उस पर मोहर तस्दीक सबत करता है जिस तरह मुल्क के तूल अर्ज में ये जनाजे आ रहे हैं तालिबान के वहां पर अफगानिस्तान से परसों ही की एक वीडियो है पेशावर के पेशावर सिटी में ये तालिबान के एक जुलूस में वो एक जनाजे को रिसीव करते हैं और वो फिर नारेबाजी भी करते हैं पेशावर सिटी में, जनाब चेयरमैन पेशावर सिटी में, फिर हम कहते हैं कि भाई दुनिया हमारे ऊपर इल्जाम लगाती है, फिर जब हम कहते हैं तो वो कहते हैं कि भाई वो किसी और की जबान बोल रहे हैं, तो जब हम कहते हैं कि अफगानिस्तान में हमारे फेवरेट्स नहीं है, हमारे अफगानिस्तान में फेवरेट्स हैं और वाहिद फेवरेट जो हमारे अफगानिस्तान में है वो तालिबान।
Ever since the 2001 US invasion ousted the Pakistani-backed Taliban regime in Kabul, Pakistan's powerful military has unofficially provided carefully calibrated support to the group, allowing Afghan insurgents to operate from its territory. Pakistan wanted to bolster the Taliban as a counter to the influence of India in Afghanistan and to have a potent proxy there after a US departure. With the Taliban sweeping through a third of Afghanistan's districts and surrounding the country's major cities, Pakistan authorities have to grapple with the unintended consequences of their politics.
We have time and time said this, that the presence of Shoras and Quetta and Peshawar and elsewhere in Pakistan have been something of great concern to us. Families still live there. You may remember that the Taliban delegation visiting for consultation to Pakistan. So yes, they have the support infrastructure currently present in Pakistan, and we would want to see that changed.
There is a possibility of Pakistan-based terror groups, including Al-Qaeda, to get more strategic space in Taliban-ruled territories, due to umbilical links between Rawalpindi and the insurgent leadership. There will also be influx of refugees across the Durand line of those trying to escape Taliban's harsh interpretation of Islam and the accompanying changeover of Afghanistan from a republic to an emirate. Besides, the rise of Islamic fundamentalism and its victory in Afghanistan will also create security problems for the region.
Moving on, Pakistan is facing the consequences of terrorism it has bred it for last several decades. Recently, in a terrorist strike, 9 Chinese workers were killed and 28 others were injured in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. Now, China has called on Pakistan to investigate the cause of a bus explosion that killed Chinese nationals. We have a detailed report.
A safe sanctuary for dreaded terror groups, Pakistan is rapidly turning out to be unsafe for its own citizens and foreign visitors. On July 14, a bus explosion killed at least 13 people, majority of them Chinese nationals, near Dasu Dam in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, a province known to be stronghold of the Taliban and Al-Qaeda. The bus was carrying Chinese engineers, surveyors and mechanical workers to the Dasu Dam, a $1.9 billion hydropower project backed by China Gezhouba Group, a state-owned construction firm. China has expressed shock and condemnation over the blast and urged Islamabad to arrest perpetrators immediately and punish them severely and protect its personnel and projects in Pakistan.
发生炸弹袭击，造成中方人员伤亡，表示震惊和谴责。对在袭击事件中身亡的中方八方人员表示哀悼，对其家属和受伤人员表示慰问。
China has been working on several hydroelectric projects as part of its Belt and Road Initiative in the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and other provinces of Pakistan. The indigenous people have been opposing these mega projects as they feel threatened due to growing Chinese influence and investment in the region. On several occasions, the Chinese workers have faced opposition from the Pashtuns, the Baloch and the Sindhi people. In April, the Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan claimed responsibility for a deadly bomb blast at a luxury hotel hosting the Chinese ambassador in southwest Balochistan province. Earlier in 2019 too, heavy armed gunmen attacked a luxury hotel in southwestern Pakistan near the China-run strategic port of Gwadar. These attacks clearly exposed the grim security situation for foreigners in Pakistan. especially Chinese nationals.
CPEC corridor, which is being constructed by China from Gadar port right up to connecting Xinjiang and Lhasa, this CPEC corridor actually runs through this area and through Gilgit Baltistan and Pak-occupied Kashmir. And in this whole area, there has been a lot of domination and a lot of hegemonistic design of the Chinese regime. And the Chinese people and the Chinese engineer, or for that matter, the Chinese leaders who are there in the construction areas in the CPEC area, try to rule over the general masses in this whole area. And there is a lot of economic and financial exploitation which is taking place of the masses in all this area. And this is something which the tribal warlords and the tribal communities in this part of Pakistan, they resist and they cannot accept this and they are not able to tolerate this. Second, thirdly, this area is extremely rich in natural resources as well as in mineral resources. And China is exploiting this in the name of development, in the name of economic upliftment as such. And China is actually gradually draining out the natural resources, the power resources, as well as the mineral resources of this whole area. So these are the major reasons as to why there is so much of antagonism as well as so much of resistance against the Chinese domination in this part of the country.
Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Balochistan provinces of Pakistan continue to remain safe haven for terrorists and extremists. Not only is the Taliban, the region provides safe haven to Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, Lashkar-e-Taiba and the Haqqani network. Even the growing nationalist movements in these provinces have given birth to violence. Several armed groups are operating in the regions who have been opposing the Chinese projects.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of NewsWeek South Asia. We will be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@nrn.com. This is Shreyasa Vijay, signing off on the behalf of entire production team of NewsWeek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.